And welcome to the first edition of the SWN Half Year Awards. I'm your host as always, Billy. Why have I done this? Really, I saw some other places doing some half year awards and I thought, you know what? Let's have a look and see what's happened in the first 6 months of 2023 and let people decide. Because I know the controversy that happened in January with our year-end awards for 2022 and all that kind of stuff. So again, I put out a vote, put out a voting form. It was open to everyone. Everyone could vote. I didn't put a vote in again. As always, I don't vote in my own year-end awards because I think that's I don't know, weights the decision maybe. Not that it really does, because once I go check the results, I don't know where my vote is. It's just comes up in a bar graph or a list and I have to count them and do a percentage and what have you. So in my head, it keeps it fair if I don't vote and there's no bias in my side of things. So yeah, we put out the post. On Twitter, month the half year awards, voting, and here we are. And I was going to do a Q&A video as well on Monday. I was actually supposed to do this results thing on Saturday, but yeah, things did not go my way that particular day. My son decided not to sleep, and by the time I actually got him to sleep, Money in the Bank started, and I was watching Money in the Bank, so. I knew nobody would watch a live video if Money in the Bank was on, so we thought we'd move this and just do it, do the results and a little bit of a Q&A as well. So I got questions through a website called NGL. It seems to be the new thing. If you remember Curious Cat, it was through that as well. So it's anonymous questions. We got a lot of questions. A lot of them I can't read out loud because it just seems to be it was more baiting controversy if I said them out loud because. Because anonymous anonymity is that the word? Just breeds terrible people. Just allows them to say what they want, and that's yeah. I don't want to get involved in that. But we do have questions. I picked out a bunch of questions, so I might be able to answer them as we go along and between each award category. On the website on swnscotland.com, we'll the full results. I'll have top five winners for each voting poll. There were seven categories in total. I thought there were six until I did a recount this morning and forgot about one of the categories, so I had to quickly put together a graphic and put that on there. So because this has been pre-recorded as well, I'll do a little after each award announcement. I'll put the graphic up afterwards. Yeah. The magic of editing. Couldn't do that live. Wouldn't know how to. So let's just get on with it. That's what you're really here for. You're really here to find out who's won some of these awards. And there is no trophies for the half year awards. So I'm putting out there now for the winners. You'll get your if you win the year end awards, there'll be trophies. But before that, so if you win the year end awards, you'll get one of these bad boys. Still have like two outstanding, one for Iron Girders, one for Moxie Malone. But yeah, that's what we do next year. We're going to do the year end awards and we're going to do trophies again. But nothing for the half year. So. I apologize for those that are expecting. Let's get to it. Wrestler of the half year. That's the first category I have on my screen here before I hit publish later on and schedule the post. Wrestler of the half year. It's been 6 months so far. A lot of wrestling has happened. A lot of titles have changed hands. A lot of possibly just big moments. Big moments for wrestlers in general. They've been able to make an impact in the last 6 months. So. What I'll do is I'll do the top three contenders on this video. If you want to see the top five, go. Actually, no, I'll do the top five. Why not? We'll do the top five. Top five in ascending order. Ascending order. That's right. Yeah. No, it's descent. I have no idea. Start from five. 5 to 1. This is not going out. I'm not editing this out because this is what you expect from the SWN podcast is slight chaos and confusion just from my face and my voice in general. In fifth place for Wrestler of the Half Year 2023, it is Andy Roberts, owner of FPWA, current UEWA European Heavyweight Champion, number five in the five best wrestler in Scotland, according to the voters here for the SWN Half Year Awards. In fourth place, Leighton Buzzard, coming off a huge run, albeit short, but he able to pack in a lot of defenses along the way of the ICW World Heavyweight Championship before he was ultimately dethroned by Aaron Echo. But yeah, top four. Number three, Caleb Valhalla, the new FCW Heavyweight Champion. in the top three spots. I think he had a really good showing in our year-end awards last year as well, and I think he's probably gonna have a good showing in our year-end awards this year. Number two, Spike Tierney. Probably a surprise, but the FCW faithful are very passionate fans, and of course he has been the junior heavyweight champion for I think most of the year, if not all the year. So he's certainly got the credentials to be in that that conversation when you're looking at pure accomplishments and win-loss record. And at number one, I don't know if anyone will be surprised me saying these words, but again, all voted by the fans. I did vote. Number one is Lost Boy Aspen, current Reckless Intent UK champion, just passing 1 year as champion. He's having great showings as in WrestleZone as Undisputed WrestleZone champion, won at the in December. Also has had a great run in Discovery Wrestling, saved the world, saved the multiverse in Scottish wrestling as well on those shows. Looks like it's just having a really great run at the moment. Surprises for me. I would have loved to see Emerson Jayne in there, of course, a big favorite of mine. And seeing guys like G Money, I would have seen in there because he's having a great run in Discovery. Joe Hendry, he wasn't voted, but again, it's not me to decide. It's not me to vote in these things. It's for other people to, and then me for me to read out the results and take all the blame. So yeah, so that's your wrestler of the year. A wrestler of the half year is Lost by Aspen. Congratulations. Questions. So obviously I've got some questions here, see if we'll get through some of them. First one I'm going to pick out is top picks for the Disco Derby tomorrow, because this came in on Friday and Disco Derby was Saturday and we're recording on Monday. But I will say though, I did go through my All About the Disco episode, and my fave five, my top five contenders, Emerson Jayne was in there, so taking that as a win. Zach Dynamite was runner up and he was in my top five as well, so there you go. I'm good. I'm very good. We've got most consistent wrestlers in Scotland. That's a good one for this particular section. Most consistent wrestlers in Scotland. Right now, just always listening to reaction, always just putting on a really great match. I want to put Caleb in there. Because he is. He's just this. He's different to a lot of things you see in Scotland right now, because he is a wholesale character. The Viking, the Norse god kind of thing. He throws people about. I think he's always very consistent on these shows, on any show that he's on, with that. Charlie Weiss, I think, is probably an underrated one. I would say he always seems to put on a really great match from what I hear and what I see. Taylor Veit as well, always consistent, putting on really fantastic showings, whether it's character work or in wrestling. Oh, there's so many, and I'm going to miss so many as well. But we're very blessed right now in Scotland for some great wrestling that you can go see most weekends, if not every weekend, except this weekend coming. There's no shows, nothing. Apparently, it's due to transmit. I've been re reliably told. I didn't know what that thing was. I didn't know what that was. So I'm now 33. I don't know these things. I never knew them before. So that was most consistent. Yeah, so many. If you had the chance, would you powerbomb Tom Atlas? That's a nice easy one. And the last one for this section, I suppose we'll go for, is Duke Cannon this century's big booty daddy? Well, in September, I'm going to be in Dundee for Fair City Wrestling Ardler Mania, so I'll be able to reliably confirm whether Duke Cannon is the big booty daddy for 2023. Hopefully he's good at maths. Moving on. Tag team of the year. Tag team. Oh, we could do that so many times. Sorry. Tag team of the half year for 2023. Again, a very, very close vote for a lot of these. We've got a lot of votes in, thankfully. Thank you very much for voting in these awards. Because without you doing that, it makes me look stupid for doing for putting it out there for you to vote. So in fifth place, we have Alex Webb and Aaron Miles of Fair City Saints, most recently being losing their WrestleZone Tag Team Championships to the Foundation of the Future. They're now popping up in Discovery, and well, they have done, not just now, but they've been popping up in Discovery and a little bit of Fair City as well. So they're starting to really push out, and I really hope so, because they're a good team. They're a really good team. In fourth place, Termination Z, that's Big Ross Houser and Darrow. I think they're currently undefeated in community pro wrestling and tag team competition. So yeah, another great choice throwing him in there. And third place is Game On. That's Duke Cannon, who we were just speaking about. and Nathan North. They're current FCW Tag Team Champions. In second place, Red Gate, Tommy Cross, and sorry, it was Jacob Deacon Wild. Is it still Jacob Wild, or is it Kerrigan now? I apologize. I've just written down Red Gate. I can go into the vote. I'll go into the voting forms. I'm sure that will tell me. Actually, no, I think the voting forms just said Red Gate. So it could be Tommy Cross is definitely in second place. Not sure if it's going to be Kerrigan, Eden, Jacob Deacon Wild that's going to be claiming the second part of that in their second place the tag team of the half year. In number one, again, I don't think it'll be any surprise when I'm going through the other four winner or four contenders there. Number one is the Foundation of the Future. They were the tag team of the year last year in their year end awards. Bruiser Brad Evans, Ryan Riley, and Zach Dynamite at their half year. Again, having a great half year. They're popping up in Disco, in Fair City, and I think they've got upcoming match with Community Pro. They're getting about, and of course WrestleZone, where they are the tag team champions right now, and Zach being Tri-County's champion there also. So another great 6 months for the Foundation of the Future, and well deserved. Let's go back to some questions then. Let's go some weird stuff here. I did get a lot of weird questions, so I'm not, like I say, a lot of them was baiting for controversy sake and some weird stuff. I keep getting a picture of a donut. I don't know what that means, and I'm too afraid to ask at this point. But if anyone does want to tell me, I'm not asking, just let me know what that means. Let's see what we've got here. Which cheese does Spike Tierney like more, cheddar or mozzarella? You like what you want, sir. Cheese is for everyone. It's that blue stuff. You can go away with that. I'm going to guess cheddar. He likes that cheddar. I mean, before he wasn't getting any cheddar and he was still doing the wrestling, but now he's getting some cheddar for it. Let's see. How much would you pay to watch the Bulgarian Baker versus Bochico? All the money that I have, and I'll leave that open-ended because I may have lots, but if you've seen the editing that I put out, I don't have enough to, I operate on the oldest laptop in the world, but I pay all the money I have to see the Bulgarian Baker versus Bochico. I miss the Bulgarian Baker. I've got W3L at the end of July. Hopefully he's able to get his visa sorted. Maybe a pre-show, maybe just for me. Even my brother will turn up and we'll just sit. We'll see a Bulgarian Baker match and everyone else can come in and see the rest of the show. I can only hope. Who's the shiniest wizard, Tegan Knox or FCW with Stevie Wizard? Well, you don't see a lot of Tegan Knox. So at the moment, I don't watch SmackDown. So you could, she might be on every show. So Stevie Wizard. I'm going to go FCW with Stevie Wizard. That's the shiniest wizard right now in all of professional wrestling. Want to go back to an award? Let's go for it. Move of the half year. So this is a wrestling move, of course. There's no transfer transactions or anything like that. Although if someone put a vote in for that, I would have really enjoyed that. So move of the half year. In fifth place is a tag team maneuver. It's Aces High by Casino Brutal. Great move, and they always nail it every time. I'm seeing a lot of discourse and great stuff on Twitter about it right now. I do enjoy that move. In fourth place, we've got the T-Pose Elbow from Ian Ambrose. Interesting choice, you know. The People's Champion himself in the Fair City and in Fife. Two separate, of course, Fair City and Fife. Because Fair City is perfect. Just in case anyone goes, it's not the same thing. In third place, the Darkest Lariat by Lost Boy Aspen. I think that won Move of the Year for our year-end awards. So congratulations for it still being in the running in the top five. Second place, Cribby Cruncher by Tommy Cross. I think that's like a curb stomp, if I remember rightly. I probably don't. And in first place, move of the half year is Caleb Valhalla with the Hell Ride. I think that won move of the year in our year-end awards 2022. So, you know, sorry, 2021. It's all starting to blur. So congratulations, Caleb Valhalla. I'll look at some more questions here. Is Aspen Faith self-conscious of Caleb Valhalla's good looks? I don't think Aspen is that laid back and cool and calm. I don't know if he has the ability of jealousy or being self-conscious. I mean, I am loving his attire right now. It's like ultimate what I would want to wear as a wrestler is just a cut-off t-shirt, some shorts and Converse and a right comfy looking hoodie. Love it. That's a disco attire or have you, or just not a wrestling attire. We get the singlet or what have you. But yeah, I don't think he has the ability of being self-conscious. And I mean, I've seen his he put a picture up, I think it was a Reckless show, of his SpongeBob or some sort of turquoise jumpsuit. You gotta be brave to wear that, and you gotta be even cooler to pull it off. And you know, I think I'd pull it off. I'd look like Tommy Pickles or something like that. But it worked. It worked for him. Speaking of attire, who is the best singlet game in the scene today? Oh, I do enjoy Aspen's ones. I like the evolution of them as they go along. They go from like black, no color, and then he adds color as with each monumental moment. I like that. Just as a story thing. I like Casino Brutale's. I think it's Mikey Devine. There's a singlet and it's like zebra print. It's just a bit bold. I like it. It's just I like a bold singlet. I am blanking on who wears singlets in wrestling right now. Ryan Riley's. I like Ryan Riley's. The gold trim for the Foundation of the Future. Even though he does get it called being a swimsuit, by many people. I do like that. That's a pretty cool one. It's simple. Black, gold. That's all you need. Yeah, so there's a couple choices out there. I'm forgetting loads. Damien's usually got cool ones as well with Revolution or that. So yeah, a couple cool choices. I like wrestling gear that looks like part of their whole thing. You know, Foundation of the Future having that gold and black because they're the foundation, they got the gold trim and what have you. And like the Aspen Evolution. Like the leopard print. Not leopard print, zebra print doesn't really fit with Casino Brutale, but because they both wear it, him and Rabbi Romero, and Mike Devine and Rabbi Romero both wear it as that kind of attire and they match, it works for me. And there probably is a reason why zebra print is involved with the always betting Casino Brutale stuff, but I don't know what it is. But I still enjoy it either way. So there you go, move of the year. Move of the half year. Yeah, so many times. Feud of the half year 2023. We've got in fifth place. The Govan team versus Thatcher's Cabinet take place at Community Pro Wrestling. That seems to be still ongoing, still spanning the main narrative of Community Pro Wrestling shows, Thatcher Wright, Cabinet, and the Govan team. Fourth place, Foundation of the Future versus Fair City Saints. That mainly took place in WrestleZone. Had a couple matches down in Fair City as well. Third place, Lost Boy Aspen. Lost Boy Aspen versus Caleb Valhalla. Various promotions, Discovery, WrestleZone being the prime examples. They may have had matches elsewhere, but that's two I can think of off the top of my head. Second place, Ronan King versus Damien from WrestleZone that kicked off the start of this year. And it's so far concluded for the time being with Ronan King stabbing Damien in the eye with glass. So we'll see what happens. Damien with an eye patch. So I'm going for Damien and eye patch. Damien like solid. I don't know the difference between snakes and Metal Gear Solid, but you know, when he comes back with an eye patch and he's all mean and go for that. Love it. And in first place, it's from Fair City Wrestling, Dickie Divers and Ian Ambrose is the feud of the half year 2023. Again, that seems to be still ongoing as well. So if you want to see the action, it'll probably be on FCW Empire on YouTube when you want to go check that out. So you'll get to see what's happening or go to a live show. There'll probably be some little piece and chapter that gets written at those events. Back to some more questions. So we've got, that's a nice one to, when we're talking about feuds, what in your opinion is the best and worst way to turn face and subsequently best and worst way to turn heel? To turn face, I like it when someone is like conflicted and they save someone, like Triple H rejoining DX in 2006, I think it was, with when he came out and he'd been a heel the whole time for a good while anyway, and he came back to save Shawn Michaels from the Spirit Squad. I like that. That most recently, like Kevin Owens helping Sami Zayn helping Kevin Owens, or vice versa, Kevin Owens helping Sami Zayn. I like that. I like that emotion where you go, come on, help him, help him. And then he does, and you're like, ah, stop it. You know, I like that. Worst way to turn face? I don't know, just randomly smiling and now being a good guy with no explanation and no motive. Give me something. Give me something to bite on. Give me something to enjoy and take and go, right, this is why. This is the story. This is why. Or just coming back from injury and suddenly they're a good guy. Why? I spent 2 years beforehand booing you, and then you take a year off because you're injured. You come back, we're supposed to cheer you? No, I want to know why. Best of worst ways to turn heel. Worst way to turn heel, I suppose. Just with I hate the like once you turn heel, and the next thing is I don't owe you an explanation. Well, then I don't owe my interest in your character. There you go. That's I'm not interested if there's no. If there's no story, there's no motive, it's just random, and we never get an explanation. That, I mean, you can drag out the explanation, sure, but if we never get it, then I have no interest. So that's probably the worst way. Best way, out of nowhere. That's the one. Most recently, I watched Money in the Bank, of course, with Shayna Baszler suddenly attacked Ronda Rousey. Why did we wait through a whole match to do it? That's logically, that confuses me, but just the outdoor awareness of it and the crowd reaction for it—that's a cool way. That's a good way. I like that. Or stabbing, you know. Let's see. Fight one Ian Ambrose sized Scully or fight 10 Scully sized Ian Ambrose. Well, Scully hasn't got legs, so I reckon I could fight one Ian Ambrose sized Scully. Although I'm seeing his pictures and his progress, Ian Ambrose's progress on the interweb on Instagram, he's getting bigger, like broader and musclier. So I better fight Scully while I still can, before somehow their jaw muscles is able to like dislocate and eat me. I mean, but Scully's really small, you know, like that's like really small, like size of this microphone. I could probably kick 10 of those. That's a question that's gonna haunt my nightmares tonight. Thank you for that. Show of the year, show of the half year next is the next award. Discovery Wrestling had some great shows this year. Fair City Wrestling, WrestleZone all did as well. A lot of other shows as well down in Glasgow, putting on fantastic shows that we're hearing great things about. But in fifth place, we've got Community Pro Wrestling, their title tournament weekender in fifth place there for the wrestling show of the half year. I again heard great things. We had a review on our site on swnscotland.com about it. A lot of great emotion moments and ending with the Tory scum winning the CPW Heavyweight Championship, becoming the inaugural champion. So a big show, a big weekend of shows, especially with the guys they had up. They had Simon Miller, man like Dennis, Derice, probably more accurately. So they've put on a great show, a great amount of shows this year with the sellouts constantly. In fourth place, Insane Championship Wrestling with Get the F Out, the first actual proper. Are they going by premium live event or just going pay per view? Since their split from WWE, and so again, I heard the great things. I didn't see that. I saw the square go. I haven't seen Get the F Out. In third place, WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy to the shock and awe of everyone who think that it's going to be number one. I went to that show. I loved it. You know me. I always love this, the old Aberdeen Wankathon itself. In second place, Fair City Wrestling, Near Mercy. That was again, it was a double show, two shows that weekend. I think it was a Friday, Saturday. So again, Fair City Wrestling placing high in our votings. So thank you for people that voted. Fair City Wrestling's do well. And in first place is Discovery Wrestling's Excellent Adventure being number one. A weird multiversal show that people are still recovering from, I think, but probably a strong contender for show of the year when the time comes at the end of the year, where we open the poll up for, we'll open the votes up for everyone to pile in. So another great show in from Discovery Wrestling, throwing it in there. So I've got two award categories left. I've got like five questions. So let's do two awards, and then finish up with a nice question. Who is better, WCL commentator Joe Fordyce or WCL announcer Stevie Wizard? Oh, it's a tough one. Both offering something different to the table. Two absolute opposites in the world. I like seeing Stevie Wizard. When I go to W3L shows, I like seeing Stevie. I mean, no offense to Fiona, who does some of the ring announcing for W3L when they come up my end in the woods up in the north. But I do like seeing Stevie. So it feels like a W3L show when Stevie Wizard's manning the mic. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll see him at the end of the month. But you know, if it's Fee, I like Fee. Fee's great. Stevie Wizard, much like Mike Musso, it feels like WCL. Who is the best heel in wrestling and why is it Wolf from Gladiators? Like, you just answered your own question. The fact that they never got Wolf, or was it Michael Van Winkle, whatever his name is? Van Wilt? The fact that Wolf never, as far as I'm aware, never did anything about with pro wrestling baffles me, shocks me. No way like, if that was nowadays, there would be a play. Someone would be phoning up Wolf constantly going, I want you on this rest. Brady will be wanting him on a Family Bash show. There's still a place. There's still a place to get Wolf on a wrestling show. And, you know, do it. Get him on a wrestling show. I think it would still be worthwhile. I mean, maybe not do wrestling, but to lead out your big bad guy, get Wolf from Gladiators? Yeah, do it. I was trying to go into a Tom Campbell impression to go and do it, you cowards. Yeah, do it. Our penultimate award of the evening, yeah, this will go out in the evening, is promotion of the half year. So again, very close contenders, a lot of votes coming in on these awards. Again, thank you for voting. In fifth place is Community Pro Wrestling. So it's headed by Ravy Davey. Community Pro Wrestling, again, as I said in the last award category, they've been doing sellout shows, they've been doing big shows, they've been great, bringing people in. They've got a great core roster, and I'm looking forward to seeing them in Peterhead at the end of the month. In fourth place, Iron Girders Pro Wrestling, our one-to-watch promotion for this year in our year-end awards that just passed. Iron Girders, again, they've got a great bunch of core talent, and they're bringing in some great people to nurture and help guide this talent a little bit more as well. So I think it's currently run by BT Gunn. Wolfgang's promotion generally, but he's in NXT at the moment. Third place, Discovery Wrestling. I've said a lot of things about Discovery, and we'll say more about them in the future because we do about All About the Disco. A great promotion that we've been putting on incredible shows. So absolutely should be in the top three. In second place, it's WrestleZone. So that was our promotion of the year and our year-end awards just passed. And second place for a promotion of the half year. Again, amazing shows. They've taken a big kind of gap at the moment, doing galas and what have you. They're back at the start of August for Battle of the Nations, which I'll be at. I'm looking forward to it. I'd like to see where the story goes now, because the last show was Avianarchy. So now we're seeing the fallout of Avianarchy at Battle of the Nations. And I'm buzzing. And in first place, promotion of the half year 2023, it's Fair City Wrestling. So they got a feud of the half year. Their tag teams are in the contendership of tag team of the half year. They're all over our awards this half year of voting. So congratulations to Fair City Wrestling. Two more questions, and then we'll do one more award, and we'll finish up. Spider-Man 1 is the best wrestling show, and Bonesaw is the best wrestler of all time. That's not a question, but I appreciate your opinion. Thank you, Alex. And we'll chip your order, just in case of adventures. Yeah, we'll chip your order, and then we'll finish up with the last question there. I like a bit of everything. I like, depends on what I'm in the mood for. Right now, I'm in the mood for a cheese and burger. So it's like two burgers, cheese in the middle, battered. Give me that. That's kind of what I'm super in the mood for right now. I love a king rib. I love a battered smoked sausage. Don't clip that. Just give me, as long as the chips are decent, I'll go for a fish. I'll go chicken fillets. I'm a fat man, and I'm not fussy what I get from a chippy. As long as there's a pickled egg in there somewhere and the chips are decent, I have a lot of choices, a lot of options when it comes to, because you never know when you go to a chippy, something might not be there. You need a backup. I've got plenty of backups. I've got backups on backups. There you go. That's insight to my my fat life. So one more question left. So let's get the last award awarded. It's match of the half year 2023. Again, lots of votes coming in. I'm very glad that they have, because we've been able to. I was thinking it would be like a lot of multiple companies popping in on match of the year, but no, they're all separate companies, all different ones, which makes more interesting, I suppose. It covers the board nicely. Like I say, we are blessed in Scotland for some great professional wrestling, and because of that, we're able to spread the votes across the country. In fifth place, it's Deadpool Danger. Casino Brutale versus Arcade Violence from Iron Girders Pro Wrestling, IGPW 10. Amazing. I hope it's on YouTube. It's not on YouTube yet. I'm going to go find it because I want to see it. Just because of the whole premise of it being the loser, whoever gets pinned loses their name. And AC Anderson, who got pinned, who's now Brody Turnbull. I love the concept. I like that what Casino Brutale do. They're one of my favorite teams going right now. Just because they're shenanigan heavy, but they're still really good in the ring. In fourth place, it's Leighton Buzzard versus Big Damo versus Andy Roberts for Insane Championship Wrestling. Get the F out. A huge monumental match because it was the main event. And then, Aaron Echo came in and played spoiler. In third place, Lost by Aspen versus Caleb Valhalla from Aberdeen Anarchy. Wrestles was Aberdeen Anarchy. Again, possibly an air shocker. People think this one was going to win. But no, the votes, there was not a lot of votes in between the top three. I'll tell you that now. In second place, it is from Fair City Wrestling, live in Tayport. It's Skye Tierney, Taylor Bryden, Nathan North, and Tom Atlas in a four-way for Fair City Wrestling. Again, Fair City, they've got their army in action, and they put in a lot of votes over the course of the seven categories. So well done to Fair City for getting another place on the board. And finally, the match of the year, number one, is from Discovery Wrestling, Excellent Adventure. It's the Foundation from the Future. That's Zach Dynamite, Bruiser Brad Evans, and Ryan Riley against Lost by Aspen, Caleb Valhalla, and Johnny Lyons from 2012. So congratulations. That's a huge... I'm just retyping. It's now Foundation from the Future, because that was who was actually in the match. I think it was Johnny Lyons 2012. I apologize if I got that wrong. But yeah, there it is. Match of the year. Match of the half year so far. And I think that, again, that'll be a strong contender for our match of the year as well when we do the year-end awards also. And that's it. That's our half-year awards done. We've got one question left. We'll answer it. Spoon's trip with three Scottish wrestlers. Who are you picking? You know. I'm going to pick just three guests that I've had on the podcast that I think we'd just have a good chat with and we'd have a good time. In general, because I know people are going to go, oh, you're going to pick Aspen. We're both very awkward people. That's just not going to work. I'm going to pick Caleb, because Caleb Valhalla is the most amazing human, one of the most best humans I've ever met. So definitely Caleb in there. I want to speak to Ian Skinner. I think I would regret that choice probably, but I want to put Ian in there. Caleb, Ian, and Alex Webb seems to pop my head because we've got this really common ground of enjoying Spider-Man and things like that. So that would probably be, it's not the most adventurous picks. I know what you're thinking. Past guests, you just had Scotty Doughty on the show. And yeah, probably. If one of them couldn't make it, hopefully Scotty Doughty is available. But I think for me, I think I know that I would get on with those three people really well. I would have a good chat and probably not speak about wrestling a whole lot. So yeah, Caleb Valhalla, Alex Webb, Ian Skinner, and again, I'd probably regret having Ian Skinner very quickly, but just one of those people that I would have. Those three people would probably speak about nothing. We'd probably speak no wrestling at all. Speak about kids or, because of course Caleb's a dad. We've got Austin Powers with Ian. We've got Marvel with Alex. Wrestling would take a back seat that day. So that's it. Year-end award, year half, oh God, I'm still getting it wrong. Half-year awards, results, that's it. We'll go full post out later, but hopefully you've seen the graphics and it all looks snazzy, and I haven't like had a meltdown. But thank you very much for voting in the shows and in the votes and the everything like that. We've got our monthly poll open right now for June, and we'll open that up first of each month to vote on the past month that's just happened. And thank you for supporting SWN and continuing to do so. So this has been Billy. I like sports. I don't care who knows. You're listening to SWN. If you're listening and not watching, that made no sense to you. But I love this t-shirt. Check us out, swnscotland.com. Go on to @ScottResnet on Twitter while it's still around. And you can. But hopefully it doesn't exceed your tweet limit that day. Facebook as well. We're going to try and use Facebook more now that Twitter's been weird. And Instagram. Maybe I'll try and use Instagram more. But thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And have a good day.